Hello all, I'm Amanda Lucas, and it is my pleasure to bring you another devotional for today. My devo today comes from the American Civil War, a big hobby of mine. Ever since I was little, and my parents can attest to this, I have studied the war between the states. To this day, my husband cringes every time we walk by a bookstore because he knows if we go in, I will find and purchase more books on the topic. As you can see from the bookshelf behind me, there's quite a few, and that's not all of them. There's more in the other room. I've read a lot of them, but not all of them. Don't tell him I said that. All right, let's jump into our devo for today. During the summer of 1863, the Confederate Army, commanded by General Robert E. Lee, was looking for a decisive victory. The winter of 1862 and the spring of 1863 saw one victory after another for the South, and they sensed that the North was reeling. General Lee brought his army north into Pennsylvania to draw out their enemy. On July 1st, the Union and Confederate armies met in a sleepy little town called Gettysburg. The first shot on that July day touched off the largest battle ever fought in the Western Hemisphere. It lasted 3 days, and of the over 180,000 soldiers engaged, more than 50,000 would become casualties, either killed in action, wounded, captured, or missing. I'll spare you all the rest of the statistics and strategy of the battle. However, if you want to know more, I'm more than happy to share another time. I'd like to look at a specific occurrence for a devotional concerning General Lee and his cavalry chief, Major General Jeb Stuart. General Stuart commanded the cavalry forces of the Army of Northern Virginia. Famous for being a dashing dresser, Stuart was known well to the opposing Union Army as a voracious fighter and a skilled tactician. Lee often used Stuart's forces to scout the area in front of the infantry and relied on his reports to make sound deployment decisions. Even more important, Lee considered Stuart to be like a son to him. In the run-up to the Battle of Gettysburg, Lee lost contact with Stuart for several days, highly unusual for the cavalry officer. Normally, reports came regularly from Stuart, but Lee heard nothing. It is said that he asked other commanders if they knew where his cavalry was, and no one did. Lee was at first concerned, but as the battle opened, he grew frustrated and eventually angry. Sources even say livid. Why was he angry? What's the big deal? Here's the problem. Because of Stuart's absence, the Southern Army was drawn into a fight that they didn't want in a location that was geographically unimportant. Stuart was the eyes and the ears of Lee's army, so he was effectively blind and deaf going into Gettysburg. This was something so completely unacceptable and abhorrent to Lee. Even though they were successful on the first day of the battle, and for a good portion of the second, Lee's anger was boiling over. What General Lee didn't know was that General Stuart was engaged in several small skirmishes, including one with our very own 1st Minnesota Volunteer Infantry at Savage Station, while trying to ride around the Union Army to provide a screen for the other infantry corps. The skirmishes turned to foraging, and the newspaper headlines started to document the panic caused by his joyriding. His arrival was delayed even further when he captured 200 wagons, and he decided to bring them with him as a gift to General Lee. Finally, in the late afternoon on July 2nd, the second day of the battle, General Stuart arrives after the day's action was done and presents the caravan of wagons to his commanding general. Expecting to be met with praise, Stuart receives a blistering rebuke from Lee and an icy cold stare that froze him in his tracks. Lee, sensing that he had hurt Stuart's feelings, softened his stance. Witnesses state that Lee went from great anger to a manner of great tenderness. He reportedly forgave Stuart on the spot and asked him for his help in the battle, stating that they'd speak no more of this. This instance with Stuart likely reminds us of times in our own lives where we've completely lost it when talking to someone we care about. Or maybe we're General Stuart in this instance, playing the role of the prodigal son. General Lee is known to have been a faithful Christian, but was given to bouts of explosive anger. It is likely that his change of heart hinged on the knowledge of the scriptures, maybe even this specific verse from Ephesians. Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ God forgave you. When we feel betrayed or disappointed, it is easier to sit there stewing in anger rather than taking the step to forgiving the offending party. General Lee was completely justified in his disappointment and anger at Stuart for basically being AWOL for several pivotal days, but where he stumbled was his reaction and interaction with the cavalry officer. He realized what he did and corrected his response and manner, in spite of the enormous harm Stuart had indirectly caused his army. Some say it cost them the battle and ultimately the war. Forgiving someone who has hurt you is never easy, but we look to Jesus as our example. He forgave people while hanging on the cross. We struggle with forgiving someone for texting us something we perceive as an insult. Slight disconnect there. In our human condition, we tend to want to mete out our retribution first rather than pausing and reassessing our reaction. Just as General Lee adopted an attitude of tenderness and forgiveness towards one of his closest officers, God does the same for us and wants us to do the same in our lives. Micah 6:8 tells us, "He has shown you, O mortal, what is good. And what does the Lord require of you? To act justly and to love mercy and to walk humbly with your God." Be just, love mercy, walk humbly. Keep calm and carry God.